Coffin. How are you today?
I'm good. How are you doing, Mrs. K?
I'm delightful.
Awesome. Should we get right into it and do our wristband challenge this week?
I think that would be great.
Sure thing.
We can have that old spinneroo thing. Oh, there we go. Yes,
You
we can.
bet. Yeah, and we took some of our names from last week because we decided that we're going to keep them all in and we're going to draw them and keep adding to our wheel for the month. So let's see how we do this week.
Right, I guess I need to do my drum roll. I really miss having kids to do this.
Nice. Macklin.
Hey, Macklin.
Nice work, Macklin. We know you've been busy. We saw you hula hooping earlier this week already, so that's great.
Yes, I loved that video of you, Macklin. That was excellent. Oh, drum roll.
Oh, his sister.
Bear! And we saw you skipping and jumping on the trampoline at the same time, Mayor. That was very creative and super fantastic. Well done to both of you.
All right, let's check it out. One more spin.
Last one, drum roll. Woo!
Nice.
Yay, Riley. Okay. Keep working hard, you guys, and make sure you keep doing some exercises. Mr. Coffin and I would love to see that wheel just filled with hundreds of names.
That'd be awesome. Hey, Mrs. K, earlier this week, Mrs. Martha Tolles in her class, they were doing something called Flipgrid, and they were telling jokes. So we actually took a couple jokes. Well, I took my joke from one of the students in Mrs. Martha Tolles' class for the week, and you've got a joke there as well.
I sure do. Why don't you go first? Because I've seen those jokes, but I don't know which one you picked, so I'm super excited to hear that.
I actually chose Ryan Moss and Dahmer in Mrs. Martha Tolles' class, and here it is. What do you get when you cross a vampire and a snowman?
Vampire and a snowman. I have no idea.
Frostbite.
That's a good one, Ryan. Way to
Yeah.
go. Thanks for submitting that. Or I actually doing it in your Flipgrid. I remember how fun that was to participate in that little session. So my joke, Mr. Coffin, this week is from Rachel Ott, and she actually emailed it to me. It is, how come dark is spelt with a K and not with a C?
I'm not sure.
Because you can't see in the dark.
That makes sense. Good
Oh,
one,
that was a
Rachel.
good one. Very
Thanks.
punny, Rachel.
Right. Thanks for sending your jokes and keep on sending us jokes, guys, because we like to feature them in our Raptor chat.
That's right. So, one more thing before we go today, boys and girls. Mr. Coffin and I, on the weekends, we have a little bit of extra reading time. And so, we were talking about today that, gosh, we would like to know some more books to read. And maybe you guys could send us some of your suggestions. So we each have one of our favorite books to share with you today, and we would love if you could take a picture with you, yourself, and your favorite book, and have your parents submit it to us. And there will be a folder link down below that they can drop those pictures into, and then we will feature them next week in our Raptor Chat or our weekly update. So,
That's
what's your
awesome.
favorite book, Mr. Coffin?
Well, my favorite book actually, and for some of the grade three students in our school, we had a bit of a reading competition while we were still in school. They were having like a March Madness with with different books. And so I read one of my favorite books to them, and it's for the older kids. So the grade threes and fours or older if you have older siblings, but my book is called Holes. And I love this book because it teaches a really great lesson about character and about being a good kid, being honest. And my favorite part of the book is about the character named Stanley, and he talks a lot about his no good, dirty, rotten, pig stealing great great grandfather, who put a curse on his family and all, or who was trying to solve a curse that was on his entire family. So Holes is my favorite book, and it's a great little chapter book to read down the road and for our grade fours.
Awesome. That sounds like a great story. My story is actually one that I normally go to the kindergarten classes in June, and I read this story because it's my favorite, and it is called Miss Nelson is Missing. And this storybook is actually about a class who doesn't listen very well to their teacher, And then she goes missing, and they have the meanest substitute teacher in the world. And then they just can't wait for their teacher to come back, and she doesn't come back for a very long time. So it's always a fun one to read and to bring out my witchy voice.
Ooh, that sounds pretty good, Mrs. K. That sounds like a good book. I like how we both chose a book. You chose a book that some of our younger kids can appreciate, and I chose a book that some of our older kids can appreciate. So that's pretty cool.
Yeah, so remember, boys and girls, we want to see what your favorite book is, and take a picture of the book with yourself and submit it down below. And Mr. Coffin and I can't wait to try some new books to read.
That sounds awesome. Hope everyone has a great long weekend and you're able to get outside and enjoy the sunshine.
Yes, have fun outside. Make sure you join our wristband challenge draw and do lots of great activities. Take care. Bye-bye.